My first brand new car I bought for myself was a 2002 Acura CL Type S, and I did everything to make sure it never got a door ding. I washed it and shit and waxed it, and the only thing that did for me is turn me into a giant douchebag. Yelling at people for dinging his car and shit. Little kids. I got in a fight with a little kid once.
What bite?
Popped him in the face with a knee.
Oh, what bite, pop!
I learned to never get attached to cars and not to care about them too much at my dad's old shop. Because I didn't give a fuck about customers' cars. So I tried to transfer that over into my real life and not give a fuck about my own cars either. Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. But you're always going to get door dings and your car's always going to get fucked up and chipped as long as you drive it and you're not a bitch that keeps his car in his garage and never drives the damn thing. So I'm best off just learning how to fix my own shit when it gets fucked up. Back to cutting my dash. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make a quick freehand template as I take the shape of my dash to continue working on my little centerpiece for my iPad mini Macintosh deck. Dash piece center console setup. Damn, dude, it's already legendary. So far, I made my DIN plate and glued my iPad mini kit to it. Now I'm just gonna make a side profile, which will be the side of the dash piece. I'm just gonna use a piece of chipboard and make a profile that fits perfectly against the dash. I just like to eyeball it and go. You get better with practice. Cut that shit, slap it on there. If you fuck it up, do it again. Now I have two perfect shapes that fit up against the dash. Now I need to duplicate these shapes onto a piece of MDF. I'm just gonna grab a couple shapes off my wall from the Mobile Solutions template set and then figure out how I'm gonna make each cut. I'm just gonna use my 1/4 inch flush trim bit and make all the cuts on the router table. I want to push this back as far as I can, but keep the full functionality of the iPad kit, and I can stick it together using some template tape and trim off what I'm not going to use on these side pieces. I'm gonna have to do it. To make this iPad fit all the way tight against the dash, I'm gonna have to cut the metal. I don't give a fuck. Some of you are cringing right now, but I don't care. I'll cut it right in half. I don't give a damn. I could always put a new dash in it if I feel like getting a new iPad. This is all trimmed up. Now the piece fits nice and flat against the dash. It's a nice low profile. The head unit is in a perfect position, so I can easily adjust my volume and my bass and my treble adjustments. Damn. Now we got a perfect dock for an iPad mini. This will fit all the way up to the brand new iPad mini 4, right above the Macintosh head unit. Now I need to find a good way to get sound from the iPad into the auxiliary input of the Macintosh head unit without losing any quality. Before, I've used an iStreamer, which has a really high-end DAC built into it, so we might go with that option. We also need to get some RCAs. We started a whole new project. Every time I go broke, I start a new project. Support Amplified by going to soundmanca.com and picking up an iPad dash kit and Soundman merch. Go to mobilesolutions-usa.com and book your car audio training and check out their tools. And go to ct-sounds.com for some innovative car audio equipment from a company that's giving back to the community. I'm just gonna keep an ongoing list and try to budget an amount of money I spend every month so I don't go broke as fuck. Busting out my Amex's ass. Blown out looking like Rafa's mom back there.
Seriously, don't fuck around right now, fuck off!
Looks like the bitch sat on an M80 when I was done with her. Let me know what you guys think of this dash piece. Thanks for watching. Make sure you hit me up on Twitter @DougBernards. I'll see you guys tomorrow.